Hey there, everyone. The main surveyor here. So I want this to be the last time I address the Earth shape debate. And the reason it's going to be the last, or trying to be the last, is because I've just about had it. So the Earth shape debate online to me looks like this. It's like a homeowner who needs to know the height of his roof, the peak of his roof above the ground. A surveyor comes over to start making measurements. And then the neighbors show up and they start arguing about what color the house is. And they think they can say because the color of the house is blue or it's yellow, they know how tall the house is. But none of them have actually measured the house. So, what's the rule there? If you want to know the dimensions of an object, what do? You just measure it. And I'm addressing both sides of the Earth-shaped debate right now. Actually, all three sides, because there's concavers around. Listen, guys, if you want to know the dimensions of the Earth, you just measure it. That's all you need to do. You don't have to have a $50,000 robotic total station to do it. Some of you guys have done some really good observations with just a tube of water to do the eye level horizon drop observation. That's fantastic. That means you measured something. That puts you light years ahead of the flat earthers who don't measure anything whatsoever. Right? And none of them do, right? So Harry doesn't. He has this video that has all the sophistication of a Gary Wibenga video. And then you've got Johnny over here who says that there's no refraction, nothing is wrong with the atmosphere. You watch the video and all these lights start shimmering. Come on. I mean, who are you fooling? He doesn't measure anything anyway, but nothing that matters. We don't know how he's 1 meter above tide level. What do you mean, tide level? See, all the sophistication of nothing. He has no sophistication. There's no difference between Johnny and Gary and Harry and all of these different famous flat earth people, flat earth Jesus, whatever his name is. Dr. John D. wanted to know if I had empirical evidence of plumb lines not being parallel, and so I sent him five emails with 18 different attachments. He's like, "Well, how do I know where you were? Where you were?" Well, why don't you be professional and just read it for what it is, pal? Why don't you do that? I mean, it's like taking an article written by someone and saying, "Oh, well, how do I know you were where you were?" I don't know if I know where you were. Come on, get with the program. So, the real problem is if you want to know the shape of something, why don't you research how to measure it, right? So, one of the predictions on the globe is horizon drop or dip of the horizon. Got this article here by H.C. Freiesleben, and he tells you that the angle of horizon drop is predictable. So, flat earthers, why don't you get yourselves a precise measuring instrument, like, oh, I don't know, a theodolite that can at least measure to the nearest 5 seconds. Even heck, nearest 7 seconds. I think that's a pretty standard theodolite that's out there, digital theodolite. Why don't you rent one of those? Set the crosshairs to horizontal, a zenith angle of 90 degrees, a vertical angle of zero, one or the other, whichever the theodolite's set to. See if that horizon is rising to eye level or not. And then I want you to measure down to the horizon. Put those horizontal crosshairs on the horizon. See what your zenith slash vertical angle is. And if it matches this prediction. Within reason. I mean, if you have to tip it down at all, then this is true, right? But flat earthers don't get that. You know, and then there's flat earthers that don't understand map projections. Well, here's some mathematics of map projections by Rod Deacon. Excellent article. Very worth your time. I can't say that I understand all the math in it, but the narrative's pretty good. And we can see that the mathematics of map projections are pretty complicated, aren't they? Flat earthers don't have this kind of ability to describe things. This is how you take real-world measurements and flatten them out onto a flat map. Pretty difficult, isn't it? Right? It's pretty complicated. It's pretty complicated. But flat earthers don't want to do that. They just want to say, oh, this is our map. Now, this is one of the worst claims that flat earthers make, this Gleason's new standard map of the world. Well, it's not actually that Gleason is saying this is a new map. It's that he has a new timekeeping device, right? Because this projection has been around a long time, and that's the funniest part of all. The word on the face of the map totally debunks your use of this, flat earthers, the word projection. Projection means we're taking real-world measurements and flattening them out onto a piece of paper. You wouldn't need a projection. And here's another problem I have with this. Why on earth does this attempt to maintain latitude and longitude values on the spherical Earth onto this flattened map? Why would it do that, flat earthers? If this is really your map, why don't you have a new coordinate system? I mean, invent something new, for heaven's sakes. Have some intellectual motivation. Don't be so lazy. This should probably just be grid lines that are vertical and horizontal. It shouldn't be pie slices. Oh, and then there's one bit of information that escapes you, flat earthers. It's the patent for this map. So here it is. There's the patent number. 497917, patented in 1893 by Alexander Gleason. This is his time chart. This is what he's patenting. Okay? That's what he's patenting. And if you come down to the end of the document, here is something really cool. He says the extortion of the map from that of a globe consists mainly of the straightening out of the meridian lines, allowing each to retain their original value from Greenwich, the equator, to the two poles. To the two poles from a globe. Do you understand what Alexander Gleason, your flat earth hero, just said? He said that this is the globe flattened out, but that the lines of longitude are being maintain their values from Greenwich. And that it recognizes the existence of two poles. So here's the North Pole, and he says there's also a South Pole is what he's saying. So your hero admitted that there are two poles and that the Earth is spherical. He did so in the very document from which his clock, his timekeeping device, was patented. He better not have lied when he patented it. Just saying, flat earthers. So you guys got nothing. It's really boring. Really, really boring. There's no precision to your language. You don't measure anything. And a lot of globers don't measure anything either. And it's like, come on, guys, this is boring. So going forward, I just want my channel to be really about measurements. And here's something I'm playing around with. I'm playing around with deleting videos that aren't measurement videos. So like flat earther photography, I can see too far. Our railroad's always flat, because it's addressed to flat earthers. Gary is wrong, FE Core, all this stuff. Because I'm bored of it. I really want my channel to be about survey measurements. I already rebranded it once. It used to be called Just a Maniac, and it was all over the place. I had model train videos. I had a video of myself playing guitar, and then I had some of these measurement videos. You'll hear where I introduced myself as Just a Maniac. I really just want to be about the measurements, because that's one of the things that I'm really into. You know, Jesse Kozlowski just emailed me over the weekend and pointed out this article to me from 2010. This article is awesome. So Croatia is trying very hard to develop a really good geodetic network, right? And this paper was presented at the EuroReference Symposium. And EuroRef is all about geodetic networks in Europe. And Croatia's trying to not be behind the times, trying to catch up. It's really cool to see a country develop this from scratch, because the United States started this so long ago, Britain before that, France before that. So it's been, the Western world doesn't see this very often. So it's very, very cool, right? So in Croatia, what they're trying to do is, from the mainland, they're trying to transfer elevations over to these islands in the Adriatic. Well, it's kind of tricky to do, because you can't do differential leveling across all this water. And so they reasoned the best thing to do is to actually shoot zenith angles across here. And it is in several places. This article is pretty awesome. So they tried a few different methods. They tried different triangles, they tried straight lines, and they found the best thing was this red, which is actually like a square, even though it does form an X in the middle. But what they did was they had two control points over here on the mainland, two control points on an island, and then they did differential leveling between these two points, differential leveling between these two points, and then they shot a zillion, that's not really a good number, is it? They shot a lot of zenith angles from these points to these points, and from here back, and they're able to get really, really good results. Sub-centimeter precision on the elevation changes between these, and the elevations, ultimately. And they also, they relied on the distance between these points with GNSS observations, which is totally legit to do that. And then the rest, the elevation transfer, they did with zenith angles, and they took into account Earth curvature, right? Earth curvature influence is one of the errors, refraction is one of the errors that they had to eliminate through their process, and they did a very good job. They did a very good job. So I want to try to recreate this kind of thing. That's what I'm interested in. I'm interested in doing my own geodetic surveys on a larger scale. Now, if I had a boat, I'd love to be able to measure from Spring Point Ledge Light over here to, say, Little Diamond Island or House Island or Cushing Island over here. Maybe use Bug Light as a back sight. I'd also like to come out here to Portland Head again. I'd like to establish the location of Halfway Rock. I think it's over here. That picture's a fuzzy. Halfway Rock with triangulation, like really big triangulation lines. I should be able to come down here to Two Lights Park and measure. Two Lights Park's down here. Measure back to Portland Head as a back sight, and then turn angles over to Halfway Rock. I think that'd be a lot of fun. Right, and you remember that I can see Seguin Island on a good day. I'd like to do more stuff with Seguin Island as well. So if ever I was to start a GoFundMe, it would be to get a lobster boat. Do you think that the community could come up with about $150,000 for me to get a used lobster boat? Scratch that. I'm not actually going to ask you guys for any money. I mean, I could use the money, certainly, but I'm not going to e-beg. There'll be no e-begging. There'll be no monetization of my channel. I'm not about that. That's not what I'm into. I don't want to be a part of that because I don't want the pressure of having to make a lot of videos when people are paying me to do it, just at my own leisure. So I want my channel to be about measurements, and I hope that that interests you. If it doesn't, my apologies, but I'm really done with Flat Earth. It just doesn't interest me because such a large segment of the globe side of the debate and all of the flat earthers are not interested in measurements, and that's boring. So if you take just one element from today's video, I hope it's that you understand when you want to know the dimensions of an object, just measure it. All right, so that's probably enough of that. So I'll talk to you all later, and I hope you have a good day.